Hello, I'm Duke of the Bump, and rumors of my demise have been greatly exaggerated. I will be playing a delightful little game for the Genesis called Castle of Illusion. Our story opens in Vera City. Man, that doesn't sound like a real place. I question the veracity of that town name. The Witch Miserabel. Boy, there's no chance of mistaking her for a good guy, is there? When your name's Miserabel, pretty much your only option for a career is Disney villain. All the way to the bank. It doesn't look like he's trying very hard, does it? He's just kind of dawdling at a faster pace. Ooh, panorama. Unlike its successor, World of Illusion, Castle of Illusion is only one player. And the story is Miserabel kidnapped Minnie because she wants to, I don't know, sap her beauty using magic or something to make her beautiful, and in turn make Minnie ugly. Although it's Castle of Illusion, only one level really takes place in the castle. Well, I guess it all takes place in the castle, you know, in the grand sense of things, but, this is the illusionary forest located inside the castle. Those things that we just picked up are apples. We can use them to smite our foes, or we can jump on them in traditional platformer manner. But if you do jump on an enemy, you want to make sure to press jump again or press down before you hit it. Because otherwise, it'll just go right through it like that, like I just demonstrated. You have to use your gluteus maximus, by which I mean your tenderloin. And of course I'm talking about the seat of power. Okay, I'm talking about the ass. And as you can see, everything sort of turns into glitter. Because it's not really there. It's illusionary. Nobody really dies in this game either. You don't have extra lives, you have tries. You have 3 tries to be exact. Also, unlike World of Illusion, you don't get unlimited continues in this game. So there's actually sort of a challenge there. That was an extra life, by the way. But, you know, like all Mickey Mouse games, it's not really a challenge. I passed up a secret back there because I can't remember which hole you have to fall down. But yeah, if you go down one of those holes, there's like an extra hit point or something. It's not worth the trial and error at this point to try to get it. So yeah, some of you, most of you are probably aware that this isn't Dungeon Hack. If you're not aware of that, then you should probably get the battery in your hearing aid changed and get a new glasses prescription. The reason it's not Dungeon Hack is because, like I've mentioned, I'm sort of burned out on that game. It's repetitive. It's a good game, don't get me wrong. I love it. I'm just starting to think that it was a poor choice for an LP. Now, as for Taz, some of you might not be aware that I was doing Taz, but people who follow me on YouTube are. I want to finish it, it's just I forgot how hard the last couple of levels are, and I actually don't know how to beat the boss that I'm currently on. If you watched the last Taz video, then that's pretty much where I'm stuck. And I could use a FAQ, or an FAQ. But, I don't really want to do that. I might have to, because I am planning on finishing the LP, but I have no idea how I'm supposed to kill, whatever his name is. The hair monster. As for Dungeon Hack, I still want to finish it. I don't know, if I can figure out a way to make it more interesting to me than I would. I think what I'm really burned out on right now is LPing by myself. It's like the last few LPs I've done have been, you know, I haven't had any guest commentary. I haven't been playing with anybody. You know, it's just me against the world. And with Dungeon Hack, I tried to alleviate that by having a little competition, but that didn't work out, and that got me, I wasn't in a very good mood because I couldn't get that to work. I felt bad that I wasted everybody's time, and, I just wasn't in a good place, but, I'm going to take a little break from the games I was playing, play something easy, play something I'm, more than capable of beating. Of course, this is only one player as well, but, this doesn't really take any effort on my part, unlike the other two games. I would really like to do another co-op game with Moors, with Mike, and we've been trying to think of something to play. We were going to do a Sega CD game called Dungeon Explorer, but that turned out to be not really LP friendly, and we were going to do Gauntlet 4 for the Genesis, but A, neither of us are any good at that game, and B, I think RPGD is already doing that one, so I wish we could find another game like Gunstar Heroes that's, fun, co-op, not really too much of a challenge, since it'll be a version LP, most likely. Alternately, I was thinking we could make a few videos for some of the competitive games that we used to play. I know that competitive games don't really make great LPs, unless you're doing some sort of a tournament, but I don't know, I think we might be able to make it entertaining. So, Mike, if you're watching this, what do you think? We could play ice hockey for the NES, or even Super Spike Volleyball on the same team. That might be fun. I think I recommended that, but we just sort of let it drop. But yeah, I would definitely be interested in, because it's called Let's Play, it's not called, Play by Myself, and, it's all me. As you can see, this is Toyland, but there aren't any babes here, just toys. So, those of you seeking babes must look to the other Toyland. The one with all the babes. So, what have I been up to for the past few weeks, you ask? Because you're so interested in me? Nothing. Part of the funk that I've been in, just life. Don't talk to me about life. Brain the size of a planet, they asked me to pick up a piece of paper, etc. But no, seriously, I'm okay. I've been working a lot for the man. These diamonds don't really do anything, but I like collecting as many as I can. Especially that group, because I love the noise that it makes. And, as you can see, the exit was here the whole time. We just had to get that key at the top. Oh yeah, there's more. I forgot. Well, damn, that means I'm not going to be able to beat Toyland in this video. That's a shame. Uh-oh. We have some obstacles to break through. Wonder what happens if you just, waste all of your items before you get to the barrier. Wonder if it gives you more, or if you're just screwed. Because if you kill the enemies, then really, you're stuck there. There's no time limit, there's no way to kill yourself. Oops. God damn it. I said butt stomp. This is one of the very first Genesis games I ever played. This and Sonic the Hedgehog 1. There's always room for Jell-O. Was that an actual Jell-O slogan at one point, or did I make it up? Now, see, the thing about Jell-O pudding is it's a lot like Kodak film. Actually, it's not really that much like Kodak film at all. I'm Bill Cosby. That's a terrible impression. Alright, and it looks like we're about running out of time, so I'll finish up Toyland in the next video. This has been Duke of the Bum. I'm not dead, I promise. The current time is 12:20. Not really, I'm just going by that clock there. See it? Oh well. Anyway, see you later.